Well,
can you raise a quiet hand if you were not here when I told the first part of the story? You were not here, okay?
I know the story.
You know it. Okay, so one or two people know it, so and we ask them not to spoil it, so please don't do that. And also, that's fine, Abby. Also, I'd like you to keep thinking about it. I want you to keep in mind that the way I tell a story, if you already know it, may be a little different from the way you've heard it before, because every time somebody tells a story, since we're not reading from a book, the words come out a little differently. But I'm going to tell you the second part of the story, and then we're going to use what we know about making our minds powerful, and I'm going to give you some questions, and we're going to discuss some questions again, okay? So remember that while I'm telling the story, you want to listen actively. And then, when we get to talking, we'll talk about these things. But you want to listen actively and be thinking, okay? I told you last time that because I haven't done a lot of storytelling like this, I learned that as a storyteller, I can make little notes to myself to help me remember my story. Sometimes with little words, sometimes with little pictures. You don't really need to see them, but I'll share them with you for those of you who are curious, okay? Here we go. Yeah, for the people who are curious. Okay, we already did that one. That's fine. Okay, here we go. Let's move this out of the way. So we know that the Greeks went over to fight the Trojans because they wanted to get Helen back, right?
Yeah.
And they went there, and remember we talked about how they fought for a day, and then 2 days, and then 3 months, and then a year, and how many years altogether?
10 years
they were fighting altogether. And what surprised them, Helen, is they thought, we're so strong, we have so many ships, we're going to go over, we're going to get Helen back right away, we'll be home tomorrow for dinner. Okay. But it took 10 years. So after 10 years, because the Trojans were so tough, the Greeks got kind of tired. And they're like, you know what, this is 10 years, I miss my family, they were all boy, male soldiers, we miss our wives, we miss our children. Maybe we should just go home. We're never going to win. And they were very disheartened. Well, they thought maybe we should give up. Well, one of the Greeks said, you know what? Have an idea. Let's not give up. And the name of the Greek who had an idea was Odysseus. Odysseus had an idea, so he gathered all of the top soldiers around him, and he whispered in the air. And he told them the idea. Okay? Now, the next morning, when the Trojans woke up, remember, the Trojans live in a city with a wall around it, and every morning they would look up over the city walls, and they would see all the Greeks camped out there with their tents, and then if they looked past the Greeks, they could see the sea, and they would see all the ships from all the Greeks. Well, on this next morning, the Trojans woke up, and they thought it was going to be another day to have war, but they looked out. There were no Greeks in tents. They looked into the sea, and there were no ships. They thought, Greeks must have gone home. Maybe they gave up. They kept looking and looking, and what they saw in the distance was something that really surprised them. It was a strange object. They didn't know what it was, but they saw no Greek soldiers anywhere, no Greek ships, but far away they saw this strange object, and the strange object looked like it was coming towards them. So there were Greeks. They spotted a strange object, and the strange object was moving closer towards the city of Troy. They're like, this is really weird. We've never seen anything like this. We're going to get 5 of our best Trojan soldiers to go out and investigate. So the 5, investigate, great word, is to figure out what this strange thing is and why it is coming to our city. So the 5 best soldiers, the strongest, the smartest, went out. They went out of Troy, the city of Troy, and they went towards this object. Now the people in Troy are going, this is really weird, I don't know what to do. The whole day passed, the soldiers never came back. The next morning, the people of Troy woke up. Once again, they looked out over the city walls. And when they looked out, there were no Greek soldiers. They looked to the sea, there were no Greek ships. They didn't see their 5 soldiers, but what they did see was this great, big, wooden horse outside. There's a big wooden horse. Imagine looking over your walls and seeing the big horse. Not like a regular size of a horse, but a giant, huge horse made out of wood. Some of you And so, the Trojans engaged in speculation. Speculation is a fancy word. They were wondering, what is this horse doing here? What is it for? Well, some of the Greeks, some of the Trojans are like, it's a monster. Everybody's talking, right? Everybody's talking about this horse. It's so weird. It's never happened before. And some of them are going, it's a monster. It's going to attack us. We have to be careful. And some of them said, it's a gift from the gods. The gods are giving us a gift for being so strong. Because at that time, although, Angelica, many people today believe in just one god, the Greeks believed there were many gods. So they thought, the gods are giving us a gift for fighting so strong for 10 years. And some people said, no, no, it's not a gift. It's a trap. The Greeks are making a trap for us. We have to be careful. Well, and the priests thought, no, no, it's a gift from the gods. We think it's a gift from the gods. Well, there was a king, Priam, and he didn't know what to do. He said, should I listen to the people who think it's a monster? Should I listen to the gods who think that it's the priests who think it's a gift from the gods? Should I listen to the soldiers who think it's a trap? I don't know what to do. Well, he went to the priest and he said, priest, what should we do? And the priest said, it's a gift from the gods. And we need to take it inside because otherwise the gods are going to be mad that we are not taking their gift and they might destroy our whole city. So the king, King Priam, he decides, I'm going to do what the priest recommends and we're going to take the horse inside. So they opened up the city gates and they took the horse inside. So they were saying, this is a gift from the gods. We've been fighting war for 10 years. It's finally over. We need to celebrate. So they had music, and they danced, and they sang, and they were celebrating that the war was over, and they were celebrating that they got this great, beautiful wooden horse from the gods. And not only did they sing and dance and laugh, but they also drank a little bit of wine. And so they got a little super happy. But after celebrating for the whole day, they all just fell asleep because they were so tired. And the city of Troy was perfectly quiet. But inside the horse, where it was quiet before, there started to be some little noises because inside the horse were 10 of the very best Greek soldiers. And in fact, on the belly of the horse, there was a trap. And when all the people of Troy were sleeping, the Greeks opened the trap door. And they went down this little rope. They went down this little rope. And they got out and now they're in the city of Troy. Well, there's only 10 of them. They can't possibly capture everybody in Troy. But guess what? During the night, all those Greeks that left the camp area and all those ships that sailed away, they came back. They were all waiting just outside the gate. So there's 10 Greeks, they kind of tiptoed over all the sleeping Trojans. They went to the city gates, they opened the city gates, and in came all the Greek soldiers. And it did not take the Greek soldiers very long to capture all of the Trojans and tie them up. And do you know what else they did?
They didn't kill them.
What?
They
got Helen. No, they got Helen. Because they just wanted to get Helen. So they danced, they drank, captured the rope. Oh, I'm on the third page ready. Oh, so they got Helen, and Odysseus, the man who had the idea, of course everybody thought he was a hero. So they were so excited because they had come to get Helen, they got Helen. All the Greeks were very happy. They left the Trojans all tied up. They went back to their ships, they all got on their ships, and they started to sail. Well, the Trojans haven't woken up yet, and you'll hear about that in the next story, and you'll also hear about what happened to the Greeks on their way home. But today we're going to pause the story, and I have a question to ask you. We're going to keep this in mind. Remember we said, how can you guys look up here and help me out, Angelica, too? So we talked about how can we make our minds more powerful, and can we have the girls read the orange and the boys in a powerful voice read the purple, and the girls in a powerful voice read the orange, and when you're not reading, you're listening actively. Okay, ready, girls, here we go.
Listen actively, read actively.
Think before. we're going to do is we're going to think. And then we're going to have a chance to speak. And the question is, thinking about this story and about life, don't answer out loud because you're just thinking. Do you think, is it ever okay for a group of people to fight or to go into war against another group of people?
Yes.
Don't answer out loud. If you think it is okay, you want to make your thoughts and mind stronger by thinking, why do you think that way? If you think it's never okay, you want to make your mind stronger by thinking about your reason. So we're going to look at the clock. We'll take 1 minute, and everybody's going to think what they think about this and why they think that way. Okay? So first of all, sometimes when we have discussions, people change their minds. So in a minute, I'm going to ask, spot. Can you quickly and quietly do that, please?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Bam. Okay. Your number one task, Angelica, I need your help. Your number one task is you're going to turn in your quads and you're going to discuss, is it okay or is it not okay? But Angelica and Apolline, keep in mind, you want to use these. I think it's okay because, or I think it's never okay because. I agree with what David said because. I disagree with what Ken says because. I want to add on to what Sylvia said and then add on. Okay, we're going to come around and listen and see how you have your discussion. Remember, what can you do if somebody in your group never talks? What might you do if somebody in your group is not talking? Yes?
You can volunteer.
You can volunteer, yes? Do you want to share your thinking? Hey, Siwan, what are you thinking about this? Okay. Remember to lean in, keep your whispers, and go.
I think fighting, huh?
Yeah, you must fight.
How are they doing it?
I don't care.
He doesn't care what.
And then
we're not talking about why and other things. We're talking about
that's a real war.
But you want to die in war?
I don't care.
You want
war.
You don't care about yourself.
Maybe they'll win.
No, you can just.
You need to war. You can war like
there has to be only one team with 1% winning. No 2%.
You crazy?
The wife will die too.
I don't care.
Machine guns are everywhere.
Yeah, I shared. Yeah, and it's not fair for other people. Let's say die and you can live.
Class.
Yes.
Do we have a few? Well, first of all, let's take a think now. Sometimes when you have a discussion and you learn more, sometimes you change your mind. Sometimes you change your mind, and sometimes you don't. You feel more stronger. So this is not about we're not like trying to win to say, oh, let's have the most people here or the most people here. It doesn't matter. This is about you and your own thinking. And really think about what you think and have a sense of self. You don't have to look at your friend and see what your friend might be thinking. What do you really believe inside? So right now, if you are feeling, yes, it is okay sometimes for people to go to war and fight, can you stand in the back?
Quiet.
And if you are feeling no, it is not okay, can you stand in the front? And if you're still feeling, I'm not sure, then you can stay there.
Oh my gosh,
more people.
Okay, here we go. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That is interesting. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, class. Find your own spot in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And yeah, now thank you. Okay, so here this is really interesting. So what happened is that this group of people was a lot. It was 8 people and it shrank to 2. So some of these people left. Was there anybody who thought it was okay in the beginning who changed their mind to be, I don't know, or no? One person did, okay? Was there anybody who thought it's never okay, but they changed to think, I don't know anymore, or yes, it is okay? So raise your hand if you were in the middle and you changed your mind. Does anybody remember? We'll just get one person. Can anybody share what did they hear that made them change their mind? What did you hear that made you change? Does anybody want to share if they heard something? Not feeling comfortable? Okay. But think about what was it that made you change your mind? Okay. Next question. I need a couple people in a discussion group. Okay. Mr. Berger needs a couple people in the discussion group. So what I'm going to, raise your hand if you feel comfortable being in the middle, sharing your thinking with others. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I think we have enough. All right. Okay, what we're going to do is if you are sitting on the blue or the green, including children, can you quietly tiptoe over to Mr. Berger? And I think we can do question 2. Our next question, and then you can decide. So we'll take a minute to think first. Come close. It's okay.
I think I'm the only one who's saying
it's okay. You're going to blow your mind. All right, here we go. my question is for you, and we're going to think first. If we decide it is okay to have war sometimes, let's pretend that we decide it's okay to have war sometimes. Should there be rules for each side to follow during a war?
Why
or why not? So, cannot allow, because you don't want to get hit. So, you can look at the clock. I'm going to ask because you're saying it out loud. I don't want you to stop other people's thinking you want to honor that. Look at the clock. We're going to take a minute to think. Do we think there should be some rules? And why should there be some rules, or why should there be no rules?
talking over other people, like somebody who's talking
quiet and a quiet person to talk. And if you notice, both times that he invited Sydney to talk, Sydney had really good ideas. So you don't want to miss out on the ideas just because someone's coming and doesn't really have ideas, okay? But really good job, you had that discussion. I noticed that David one time was like, now I agree with, and also Joel, you changed your mind too.
Did it too.
So what made you change your mind? What did somebody say to make you change your mind? Oh, so you change it there and back again. How about you? You change me, maybe you change your mind. So do you think there should be rules or no rules now?
I think there should be rules. Because
what made you change your mind?
Darren, because there's rules, then you can't do something you wanted to do. You have to ask someone to go, and he might say no, or she.
But then you're a soldier, and you're not a team.
Okay, we've got
deciding
one more. We have one more discussion question. I'm going to tell it to you, and we're going to think about it while you're very, one who's very quiet, maybe you walk around. Walk around has to be really quiet. Wait, we need a question first. Thank you so much, yes.
All right, well, raise your boards, put them away. You guys go ahead and get yours in water and have some arrows possible.